Welcome to motherfucking Don Flaco Media. I'm back and better than ever. We on our way to pick up my new front bumper. I got a new front bumper for the E60. I got my boy, Cholo the painter, the one that painted my RX-8, the Mazda. I gave him the front bumper for him to paint. I gave him the bumper yesterday, and it's already today. That's why I love that nigga. So I'm on my way to his house to pick it up. I'll catch y'all there. So this is the new bumper. Executed flawlessly. OEM paint. This is the M5 bumper. Bought it on eBay. Came from Cali. Bought it with the sensor holes, so I don't have to drill holes. But let me show y'all the other one, the old one. The old one looks crappy. Seen better days. As you can see, it's scratched up, broken in pieces, destroyed, peeling, scratched up. I mean, it could be fixed if somebody wanted to fix it, but I ain't trying to fix it. I might try to sell it if somebody wants it. So yeah, I might do this. Wait, let's appreciate this fitment right here. Bam. But I might install it this weekend when I have more time. But yeah, this shit looks good. Today is Sunday. I said I was gonna change my bumper Sunday, and goddamn it, I'm gonna change my bumper Sunday. So that's what I'm about to do. I am moving all my cars. I had to move my mom's car out the driveway so I could pull in the Beamer. So I'm about to pull in the Beamer now and then let the nightmare begin. All right, so car's in, sun shining, music on full blast. New bumper. Shout out to Ruby. And let this nightmare begin. So I think I gotta remove my front headlights. All these shits right here. I think I might have to remove my wheels. Cause I don't know if y'all, there's some clips right here. Run all along here, some 10 millimeter bolts. So I may have to take off my tire. I don't know yet. And I need a new, I don't know if I should get a new fender or just get it rolled again. I don't know if y'all can see it, but the tire grabbed it and sucked it in. And I cracked the fender right here. Trying to fix this problem, I made it worse. I forgot to heat up the fender and I cracked that shit. But yeah, I don't know. That's the next fix up, but we focusing on this today. All right, so both headlights are out. One, two. I suggest putting some tape on your fender because there's a lot of wiggling you got to do to get the headlight out. This side was a pain in the ass. That side came out smoothly. But yeah, put some tape on your fender if you care about your car. If not, fuck it, send it. But next, gotta take this out. It's like little clips, and then you see those T15, whatever bolts they're called, bougie ass bolts that BMW uses. Gotta take those out. And then I got these that I gotta loosen up from underneath, which I hope I don't have to take off my tire. You can see my tire right there. Hopefully I don't have to take off my wheel. And then the sensors and my fog lights. So that's next. All right, so bad news. Try to loosen these up from the inside over here, on my side. But I don't have enough room to loosen it up. So I'm gonna have to take off my wheel and reach from this angle. But I'm gonna just focus on my fog lights. I'm gonna take them out, disconnect them, as well as the sensors. I'm gonna take my tire out last. Also, make sure you guys have a handful set of these little, whatever they're called, T15, whatever. Even the fog lights have them. You're not gonna get anything done if you don't have this. All right, so I got the fog light out. So it's basically this clip and then those two bolts on the side, and apply a little bit of force and it pops right out. But again, I reiterate, if you don't have this bolt and you own a BMW, you're wrong. Fix yourself. You're not gonna survive without this. All right, so this is out, and let's repeat the same process on the other side. All right, so I managed to take out one bolt without taking out the wheel. Hopefully I can get to the second one. Third one, I turned in the wheel. Hold up. Turned in the wheel a little bit, so I might be able to get to it. If not, then you have to take out the tire. All right, so three clips are in. I managed to get all three out without taking out my wheel. The bolts up here are off. Fog lights are out. On this side, I'm not gonna be able to take out the fog light from above because of this. But as soon as I take the bumper, it's just gonna fall down below. Next step is to, I guess, wiggle it out. Wiggle this out. And then take off the sensors. And I think I'll be ready to put in the new one. Matter of fact, I lied. There's still some bolts I gotta take off right here. Another side. Maybe, I doubt anything from underneath. Let me do that now. All right, so bumper's finally off. I just had it unclipped just right here. This plug is for the sensors, the parking sensors. The other one's for the fog light. The old one's over here. New one. Now I gotta swap over the grill. These sensors, the parking sensors, and I think that's it. All right, so let's get to it. Right, Ruby? 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 Yeah, let's get to it. All right, so when you're taking out the grills, make sure you're unclipping the black tabs, not the metal ones, the black ones. And be very gentle. I broke one so far. I got this side already. Remember, yeah, the black tabs, not the metal ones. Cause you need this whole thing. Not just the metal or the chrome. You want the whole piece, the whole assembly. All right, for the sensors, real easy to take off. Just, there's these clips right here on both sides. You spread them out. Spread them out and then pull it out simultaneously. And I believe I need this for the new one. I don't know if the new one has it. I gotta go check. But yeah, that's easy enough. I already swapped out the grills. All I gotta do is the sensors next.
All right, so we're almost there. Sensors are in. They fit perfectly. Grills are in. I'm doing the fog lights. One thing I had to do is steal these tabs from the old bumper and then slide in right here. Like so. So make sure y'all do that part. If not, your spotlight's not gonna sit securely. So yeah, let's get to that.
Mental note, make sure you guys remove this piece from here, because if not, your fitment's gonna be all wonky and the bolts won't tighten up. So make sure y'all take this piece out, swap it over.
All right, so bumper is on. Right now I'm gonna check on the parking sensors. Supposedly. So I think they're working.
Echate pa' atrás. Hey, say, acércate. La otra esquina.
Yep, they're working.
Funciona.
All right, so that's working. Thank God. I was very gentle with them. Now the last step is to put the headlights back on. Tighten these. And I should be good to go. Fog lights on. All right, so we all finished. Oh, fog lights working, halos working, headlights working. Bumper looking fresh. Good to go. I did manage to break something in the process. Broke this clip right here, and the other one over here, broke that. But we good, car's running. That's all that matters. So yeah, that's how you remove or replace E60 front bumper, M5. Well yeah, that's it. There and done. I'm about to take it for a drive. Hopefully this shit will come flying off. I hope not. I'll be very, very mad. But yeah, thanks for watching. Appreciate y'all. Appreciate y'all a lot, a lot, a lot. Next step is to do my front fender, driver's side. Oh, and surprisingly, I managed to sell the old bumper for $100. So I came out winning. This one cost me like $240. No. Yeah, like $240. I sold the old one, the old broken one, for $100. So yeah, I came out winning. But yeah, appreciate y'all. Make sure to comment, like, and subscribe. Let me know.